What's going on, fellas? Welcome back to the channel. My name's Grizz. Today we're going to be doing a Black Ops 4 Zombies video, and we got a lot of movement coming from Treyarch in these next patch notes. So, towards the end of this video, I'm going to be reading the latest patch notes when it comes to Black Ops 4, including zombies, face paints, some other stuff with tier progressions at Operation First Strike, lots of good stuff. We're going to talk about all that here coming shortly. Let's talk about what you need to start this out, okay? This is going to be a glitch on the map classified. You're going to need to equip the Ragnarok DG5s. This is how we're going to get into this. And we'll be showing you two spots. One spot in particular is a God Mode spot. The other spot is a spot that you're going to need to get into just in case you screw up. I just entered Prestige 8. This is where I'm at currently on my road to Master Prestige level 1000. So if that's something you're interested in, feel free to subscribe, man. I'd love to have you along this journey. But right now, down in the comment section below, let me know your current level in Black Ops 4 Zombies. But to start things off, let's go ahead and build the shield. On the map classified, you can build the shield. It takes three parts. Go collect them, build the shield up here in the central filing area, and then we'll be popping, all right? So pick that sucker up. This is gonna be pinnacle. We're gonna absolutely need this to move forward. So build the shield. Then what we're going to do is unlock Pack-a-Punch. We need to go to Pack-a-Punch because we got to get rid of both our primary and secondary weapons. We're not Pack-a-Punching any weapons. Why? Because we're going to use those DG5s to get unlimited special. That's right. Unlimited special on this map as well. If you've missed the other two maps I've covered, the map 9 and I covered the map Blood of the Dead. Both of them have unlimited super glitches too. And I'll be showing you the one right now on Classified. So let's go ahead and get this sucker up to DEFCON 5. If you've played the map 5 before, you know how to do this, alright? But this is going to take us to Area 51, and that's when things are about to get real, real naughty, okay? So if you're good with the Ragnarok DG5s, you can get into a lot of glitch spots here by doing this glitch, but I'm going to show you how to get the unlimited Ragnaroks first. So let's go ahead and get rid of our weapons. We don't need them. We got to get rid of them. We just need our fists, okay? Same process as before, alright? We're trucking along, we're getting that XP, and just as a side note to all of you guys who are wondering, is this glitch going to last forever? No. It's eventually going to be patched and not working, so we will at some point not be able to get unlimited supers, but if you're interested in pileup glitches, ones you can get into and use double Pack-a-Punch to your advantage to get to high rounds, those will be glitches I'll be covering once the unlimited super's gone, so that's why you should subscribe. But now we're back to our fists, right? We gave both of our weapons to the Pack-a-Punch machine. Jason Blundell, you're welcome. We're heading back. We're heading all the way back, fellas. We're going back into the Pentagon. Now that we're here, we're going to activate the unlimited super glitch. You absolutely cannot have weapons in your hands to do this. I screwed up the first time I tried this. That's why I got one life. I had two weapons while I tried this. Make sure you get rid of your two weapons first. But since we got a shield, we built it, that's what's going to help us. This is the spot right here. There's a little power box that you're seeing that I keep trying to look at right here. This power box you can actually hop on top of. It's very difficult to do. But talking about the glitch again, pull out your shield. Let the zombies take you down with your shield out in front of you, right? They're going to need to hit you from the back, take you down. I recommend whatever type of glitch you're about to hop into. I'm going to show you one that I just couldn't get into, but there's one right here. You down close to it. So if you're going to go down, make sure you down really close to it. The reason for this is your super only lasts so long. But once it runs out, it will be infinite, but you'll run out of the jump ability until it recharges again. And that's how it works. That's how the unlimited super glitch works. It'll get you all kinds of kills, but the pulse is what we wanted. That's why we have it here. You see, and I'm struggling getting into this, but this is exactly how you do it. You jump, move forward, slam on top of this power box. But let's just say you're in this situation. The place that I got for you is downstairs. We're gonna head into this next, the room next to power. And there's a little window here you can hop on top of. This back portion is the portion that I recommend, mostly because there's a further gap that they need to run to you, and you can kind of prepare yourself and how you need to move, just in case. But you need to be active in this location. You need to make sure that those little crawler guys, they don't lift you out of this spot and you're gonna die. So what you can do here and from this spot is you have a way to kind of wing out and around, and then you might get a pulse in to resituate. So that's why I'm gonna recommend this back window seal, the back part of it here versus the front part. Because I'm going to show you the front part. It's also very successful up until about round 20. At round 20, there's going to be too many flooding in. But as I said before, if you can actually get into a God Mode spot like this one here, I'm not able to get into it. I just could not do it. But no, it's possible. It's not patched yet, but it will be patched sometime after the date that this video was uploaded, okay? You can hop into here. You just have to get the hop right. And my boy Jay Stone knows how to do it perfect. I don't know how he does it. But I know it's possible. I've seen him do it quite a few times. But this is the other part of the windowsill that you can slide on into. And up until about round 18, 19, 20 in there, you're going to be fine. You're not going to run into too many problems. But after that, it's going to start getting hectic. And it's those little Nova crawlers that cause all the problems. When they come over, they don't die right away and pulsate out. That's why in every other map this works perfectly, because you don't have an enemy type that does that to you. But the Nova crawlers can cause problems and get you killed. So this is a spot I'd recommend up until about round 20, and this is the just-in-case spot, let's call it that. This is the just-in-case spot in case you can't get into the other God Mode glitch and your super's out. Come run into this windowsill, and you can hold down for a little while. So there you have it. There's the unlimited special glitch on the map, classified. Feel free to use this and get in any glitch spot that you can jump into with Ragnaroks. This is an awesome one. I'm glad I could bring it to you. Now, let's go ahead and talk about these patch notes. All right, what exactly changed? What's going on? What's Treyarch talking about? Lots of news to cover today. With last week's launch of the Black Market for PlayStation 4 players, the earn rate for unlocking the Black Market tiers did not perform as we intended. We've implemented a change that addresses some issues and rebalances the system across all modes and as everything it should be. This is an ongoing process to dial it into everything that it needs to be. As of today, players will now earn tier progress both faster and more consistently across all modes that are blackout or multiplayer. In addition to the base earn rate, we will also be bringing online earn rate accelerators and challenge-based and event-based tier skip rewards in future updates. So that's something we can look forward to as we upgrade what some people are deeming the new Battle Pass. This is the Black Market Pass. The earn rate of tiers did get a buff, so tier progression's a lot more fast. I definitely wanted to bring that into limelight. Here's what they had to say about zombies. There was some miscellaneous stuff. They resolved an issue where war paints were not showing up in the reward stream until they were unlocked, and they also fixed multiple crashes. So we have yet to fix the blue screen problem. It's happening a lot less, but it's definitely still an issue, especially if you're going into the late 30s or early 30s and you're trying to do the Easter egg. There's still problems with the blue screening, and I think the Easter egg just has something to do with it. It's hard to be sure, but we did get an update on zombies host migration. What they had to say was this: we're aware that matches and zombies have been ending when the host leaves the game, and we're planning in a future update to address this. So if this is something that you're also excited about, interested in hearing more on the progression of how things are getting fixed in zombies, I like to cover all the patch notes at the tail end of my glitch videos. So if you want new glitches, new ways to rank up fast and level up fast in Black Ops 4 Zombies, this is the channel for you. I'd love to have you along. Feel free to subscribe, activate that bell notification, and I'll see you in the next video. Violent out.